Have you ever been in the situation where you do not have access to your PC but at the same time you wanted to edit some of your code? This happened to me when I was on the vacation and there was an urgent issue where I had to edit some of my codes with mobile. If you don't know, in the past I was one of the mobile coder because I don't have the PC, so there were no option other than mobile. Which is why I started coding on mobile, and if you see my old videos then you can clearly see that I was using a mobile. From personal opinion, I would say if you cannot afford a PC or you don't have one, then using mobile to code is not a bad idea. So if you are a mobile user who is looking for some good apps to code stuff like Discord bot or some other node.js project, then you clicked on the right video because I'm going to show you top 5 applications to code on mobile. On the number 5 we have Icode Go. This app doesn't really focus on UI. What it focuses on is the tons of great features and tools. You can see in the app that there are a lot of options like line wrapping, bracket matching, smart highlight and many more. If you don't know, these all features comes very useful and handy while coding. Currently I am running node.js project on this app, and to do so you will have to install another application along with the app. The most important part is that you can find external application for this app on Play Store, but you won't see app itself on Play Store. I was unable to find it, so I had to download it through the website. This app is really amazing and what it offers is truly better than what other apps are offering. You can literally install MySQL database and Apache web server on it. Now if I click on a node.js project, then the list pops up with having options like color picker, code snippets, beautifly, dynamic responding and many more. The most advanced option that developer implemented is the inbuilt terminal and npm package manager. And this is not all what they offers. If you click on three dots, then another list pops up with having some more advanced features. Overall, this app is full of professional and advanced features. I really recommend you to use this app, but keep in mind that it does not support all the languages. The languages it supports for now are JS, Python, HTML and PHP. The app is on number 5, that doesn't mean it is bad or something like that. So don't judge any of these apps by their list number. Moving on the 4th app, we have Astro on the list. This app can be found on Play Store, but you will have to download the app externally because of some issues in the app. You can find the latest version of this app on their Discord server. As soon as you open the app, you can clearly see template options, which includes Vue.js, React.js and finally Node.js. This app doesn't really have an impressive UI, however, it sure fulfills your needs. It also has an inbuilt npm package manager and the terminal. Overall, this app is easy to use and had an inbuilt browser, so you don't really need to go to your browser to test web servers and related stuff. Moving on to the 3rd app, we have Spck Pro. Actually, this application have 2 versions. First is Spck Editor, in which you can edit and manage files, but you cannot use terminal. On the other hand, in Spck Pro, you can edit the file and can also have access to the terminal. But with the free plan, you can use terminal only for 1 hour a day. You can just buy premium only for 85 rupees a month, which is around $1 per month. In my view, it is better to buy premium for this application rather than buying premium for some bot builder application. Anyway, let's talk about the features of this application. Everything is almost same in the both application except terminal feature. This application has quite convincing user interface. I really like this application as it has sleek animation and have a quite good features like get out, autocomplete, key bindings, word wrap, and also has a theme option where you can switch between light and dark theme. It also has a bunch of project templates like TS, HTML and Bootstrap, React, Vue2, etc. Moving on to the 2nd app, we have CodeSnack on the list. CodeSnack is a cloud-based IDE, which means it compiles your whole code on the cloud, so there is no load on your device. It doesn't really have a lot of features, but it does support most of the famous languages. The most amazing part in this app is that you can learn while coding. I mean, this app provides the fundamental tutorial of the language with the examples. If you are new to programming and you are looking for good apps to start, then this app is the best choice for you. As you know, everything which include cloud doesn't come free. They have premium membership which will allow you to run your app 8 times faster than before. You will able to sync between devices and will also have full access to the extra library of tutorials. Those were the premium features for the app, and if you feel like it is worth to buy it, then there is no shame in doing so, because I think this app is a really great app. Now moving on to our last app, which is Dcoder. Dcoder also compile and store all your files on the cloud. You have the max limit of 300 MB with free plan. But Dcoder also have another limitation, which is point system. You get 200 points every month and those are used when you code in the app. I don't really like the idea of point system, but it cannot be helped. This app provides git option, template, article, question queries, code sharing, and it also supports other famous languages. Overall, this app has freaking built-in community in it, where you can code, share, chat, ask questions, and do challenges.